Hi everyone, welcome to Bodyworks Prime. Today we're going over the origin, the insertion and the action of the quadratus lumborum muscle.
Pictured here we can see the quadratus lumborum from a posterior view. So posterior, meaning from the back of the body. The quadratus lumborum is often abbreviated to QL for short, so you might hear some people referring to this as a QL muscle. Quadratus lumborum, although located in the lower back region, isn't actually classed as a lower back muscle. This is because it's such a deep muscle, it's actually classed as a muscle of the posterior abdominal wall. Another thing to bear in mind about this muscle is that it doesn't connect all the way to the tip of the 12th rib. So you'll notice that this little section here, there's no quadratus lumborum connecting to it. However, you'll see in some textbooks or drawings or even 3D anatomy applications that you might download that the quadratus lumborum covers the entire end of the rib here and connects all the way to a tip. Unfortunately, this is a common mistake. The quadratus lumborum doesn't actually connect all the way to the tip of the rib. So we've swapped over to an anterior view now so that we're looking at the skeleton from the front. And this is because all of the origins and insertions we're going to look at next are on the anterior of the bones which they connect onto. So you can see I brought the origins into view now and they're marked out in red. And we'll start off by going over this here, which is the iliolumbar ligament. And this ligament essentially connects the fifth lumbar vertebrae, which is this vertebrae right here, onto the ilium itself. And this section of the iliolumbar ligament is connecting onto the iliac crest. And the iliac crest is this ridge which runs across the top of the hip here. So in terms of what the quadratus lumborum connects onto, it connects onto this section here of the iliolumbar ligament, and then it connects onto the inner lip of the iliac crest, specifically this area which I've got marked out in red here. Moving on to the insertion points next, you can see I've got them marked out here in blue. And we'll start off by going over these bony projections which are coming off the right and the left side of each vertebrae. And these bony projections are called the transverse processes. So the quadratus lumborum is inserting onto the transverse processes of L4, L3, L2, and L1. In addition to these transverse processes, it's also inserting onto the 12th rib, which would be this bottom rib right here. Specifically, that would be the inferior border of the 12th rib. So the inferior border would be the bottom part of the rib right here.
So let's take a look at the actions next. So we've got the quadratus lumborum muscle coming up here and connecting onto the 12th rib. And that 12th rib is going to bring us onto our first action, which is to brace the 12th rib to assist in inspiration. So inspiration would be breathing inwards. And it achieves this by creating a stable base for the diaphragm. So bracing the 12th rib to assist in inspiration, that's our first action. Moving on to second action now, that's going to be extension of the trunk. So if I'm to crunch my abdomen forward like that, that would be flexion of the trunk. And as I come backwards like that, that would be extension. So don't mistake that for the hips hinging. We're talking about this section right here, that's the trunk. So the opposite of flexion as you come forward, that would be extension. And it's going to be when both sides of the muscle contract together. That's going to be when it's able to assist with extension of the trunk. So that would be bilateral contraction. Let's say just one side of the muscle contracts, so that would be unilateral contraction. That's going to be able to assist in lateral flexion, so bending to the side essentially. Now both of those actions right there, it's a very weak contributation compared to other muscles. So a really good study by Phillips and colleagues, they looked at the biomechanics of the quadratus lumborum muscle, and in their study they found that the quadratus lumborum was only able to contribute at best 10% of the force that the erector spinae muscle could during extension of the trunk. So that's something to bear in mind. It's able to contribute to these movements, but it's in no way the primary mover when it comes to extension of the trunk or lateral flexion as well. As well, it's also able to assist in stabilizing the pelvis and the spine as well. So that's going to be its last action there, stabilization of the spine and pelvis. So if you've enjoyed this video or you find it helpful, you know which buttons to press. Press that like, subscribe, let me know what you've thought of the video in the comment. And I'll put a link in the description box to the Quadratus Lumborum article which I've wrote, so if you want to see that reference by Phillips and colleagues and read the paper for yourself, check out that link there. It's a really good paper. It's actually full open access, so you don't have to pay for it or anything like that. You can read the whole thing. Thanks again for watching, everyone. See you all next time.